Welcome. In this video, we'll talk about the passive sign convention. Before we go into the details of the passive sign convention and take a look at what it actually means, let's quickly define two parameters, active circuit elements and passive circuit elements. Basically, active circuit elements can be defined as those circuit elements that produce, that generate power, so like a voltage source or a current source, whereas passive circuit elements are elements that would consume or dissipate power. For example, resistor, capacitor, inductor, and so forth. So passive sign convention basically comes from, it's a convention that basically exists because both voltage and currents have polarities. And we need to make sure that if we define the polarity of the current, so the current flows through an element, and voltage is measured across an element, we need to make sure that the polarity of the voltage and the polarity of the current have some kind of relationship between them. So passive sign convention basically says that for any passive element, the positive current enters the node at which the positive voltage polarity is defined. So for example, let's take a look at a very simple, let's take a look at a passive element called AB. Right here, A and B are the two nodes labeled. So let's say that this particular passive element had a plus minus voltage labeled this way. So the polarity of the voltage was positive towards A and negative towards B. Passive sign convention says that the positive current enters the node at which the positive voltage polarity is defined. So in this case, the polarity of the current or the direction of the current is determined by the polarity of the voltage we picked. So current would be shown and drawn as such. So here would be the direction of the current for this particular case. Now let's do the opposite. So for example, let's say that we started out with this particular element and defined that the current was actually flowing in this direction. So we first define the flow of the direction of the current. Now we need to figure out which way is the polarity of the voltage. Now passive sign convention says that the current always flows from the positive voltage terminal and exits on the negative voltage terminal. So that becomes the polarity of the voltage. Okay, so another example, if we define that the current was flowing through this element in this direction, we're basically suggesting that the voltage polarity is positive on the top and negative in the bottom. And if we suggest that the voltage for this element, for example, is positive on the bottom and negative on the top, and we define the voltage this way, we're basically defining that the current polarity or the flow of current is from the bottom B node to node A. So this particular way of indicating voltage and current polarities is called passive sign convention. Consider this circuit with a 9-volt source. That's an active element, 9-volt source, three passive elements called A, B, and C. In this case, before we start circuit analysis, we need to first label the voltages and the currents for each of these elements. And to do so, we basically randomly pick either the direction of the current for each of the element or the voltage polarity, and the second one will follow based on what we picked. For example, let's say that we decided that the current flowing through A was from left to right. Now, following the passive sign convention, we would now, the flow of the current dictates that the voltage through A is plus on the left and minus on the right. So that's current flowing through A. Let's say that we decided the voltage on C was positive on the bottom and minus on the top. We're basically saying that for our circuit analysis, the current direction basically goes from the bottom to the top. Then right? For B, let's say we decided the voltage was flowing from the right towards the left. Current was flowing from the right towards the left. In that case, we're basically defining the polarity of the voltage B in this manner. And we'll call this IB. We can start our circuit analysis using this set of current direction and those voltage polarities. Now, if we didn't start out this way, we could have started with this exact same circuit by saying that the current A flows, current and A flows from right to left, in which case this polarity would have been minus plus VA in this matter. We could have decided that the current on B flows this way, which would have been plus minus VB in this manner. And we could have decided that the voltage polarity for C is plus on the bottom and minus on top, which is VC. In other words, the current flows on C from the bottom top. So circuit analysis for this circuit with same names VA, VB, VC, and current IA, IB, and IC would lead me to a different answer with different circuit, would lead me to current magnitudes but different polarities than the one if I had done in this matter. So it doesn't matter which direction of current we pick for the different elements, as long as we stay consistent and follow the passive sign convention for each of the elements. In other words, if I pick the voltage polarity for the element, I need to pick the right direction of the current for that element. Or if I pick the current first for that element, I then pick the right polarity of the voltage for that particular element. So that is passive sign convention.